World War I officially began on June 28, 1914, when members of the Illuminati Black Hand secret society assassinated Archduke Franz Ferdinand. Europe quickly polarized and warred for nearly a year before Americans were given their false flag reason to join. On May 1, 1915, the British naval cruiser Lusitania was scheduled for Liverpool, taking off from New York Harbor, loaded with 600 tons of explosives, 6 million pounds of ammunition, 1,248 cases of shrapnel shells, other war materials, and last but not least, American passengers. The German embassy in D.C. was fully aware of the war materials being shipped into England on the Lusitania and tried to warn the American travelers. German embassy officials attempted to place full-page ads in 50 U.S. newspapers reading, "Notice, travelers intending to embark on the Atlantic voyage are reminded that a state of war exists between Germany and her allies and Great Britain and her allies. Travelers sailing in the war zone on ships of Great Britain do so at their own risk." Due to actions taken by the U.S. State Department, 49 of those 50 newspapers never ran the ad. Gary Allen wrote, "The same crowd which manipulated the passage of the income tax and the Federal Reserve System wanted America in the war. J.P. Morgan, John D. Rockefeller, Colonel House, Jacob Schiff, Paul Warburg, and the rest of the Jekyll Island conspirators were all deeply involved in getting us involved. Many of these financiers had loaned England large sums of money. In fact, J.P. Morgan and Company served as British financial agents in this country during World War I. The German government took out large ads in all the New York papers, warning potential passengers that the ship was carrying munitions and telling them not to cross the Atlantic on it. Yet the sinking of the Lusitania was used by clever propagandists to portray the Germans as inhuman slaughterers of innocents. Submarine warfare was manufactured into a cause célèbre to push us into war." Midday, May 7th, off the coast of Ireland, the Lusitania was ordered to reduce speed, and Juno, its British military escort vessel, was ordered to withdraw. Committee of 300, 33rd degree Freemason, and Lord of the Admiralty, Winston Churchill, knew German U-boats were in the vicinity and purposely called off Juno, leaving the Lusitania a sitting duck. Jim Mars wrote, "British Commander Joseph Kenworthy, on duty when the ship was sunk, later revealed that her military escort was withdrawn at the last minute, and her captain ordered to enter at reduced speed an area where a German U-boat was known to be operating. It is clear why Germany attacked this ship, and Britain would have done the same if U.S. munitions were being shipped to Germany. The Germans, whose torpedo struck the liner, were the unwitting accomplices or victims of a plot probably concocted by Winston Churchill." Fritz Springmeier wrote, "The Lusitania was a ploy. It was packed with some Morgan-owned ammunition, had been given over to England as a member of the Navy, and despite the warnings of the Germans, was sent into a naval war zone, specifically to be a target, the catalyst for America's entrance into the war. Churchill ordered the Lusitania's naval escort to return to port, and the fated ship was left unprotected to be sunk. Rothschild agent Colonel House probably knew of this plot. Records point to a discussion of it between him and Sir Edward Grey of England. Historian Colin Simpson called the sinking of the Lusitania, quote, the foulest act of willful murder ever committed on the seas." Churchill's fellow Committee of 300 member, CFR founder, and Rothschild agent Colonel Mandel House was also President Wilson's top political advisor. Wilson said, "Mr. House is my second personality. He is my independent self. His thoughts and mine are one. If I were in his place, I would just do as he suggested." This is a man who has also been called the Henry Kissinger of his day. In the book, The Intimate Papers of Colonel House, is a conversation recorded between Colonel House and the Foreign Secretary of England, Sir Edward Grey. Grey asked, "What will America do if the Germans sink an ocean liner with American passengers on board?" And House answered, "I believe that a flame of indignation would sweep the United States and that by itself would be sufficient to carry us into the war. Just as luck would have it, that is exactly what happened. Around 1,200 were killed, including 128 Americans. This act set off a firestorm of anti-German feeling throughout the United States, fanned by the Rockefeller-Morgan-dominated press. So Illuminati Morgan-owned ammunition was loaded on a ship with American passengers. Committee of 300 and 33rd degree Mason Winston Churchill ordered off the ship's military escort, knowing German U-boats were standing by. Then the Rockefeller-Morgan-dominated U.S. press helped stir anti-German sentiment until the people were sufficiently propagandized to enter the war. President Woodrow Wilson, like Winston Churchill, the Morgans and Rockefellers, knew of the Lusitania's pre-planned fate, and he knew the decision to sink it was out of his hands. Colin Simpson wrote, "There can be no doubt that President Wilson was told of the character of the cargo destined for the Lusitania. He did nothing, but was to concede on the day he was told of her sinking that his foreknowledge had given him many sleepless hours." Gary Allen wrote, "Woodrow Wilson was re-elected by a hair. He had based his campaign on the slogan, 'He kept us out of war.' Just 5 months later, we were in it. The same crowd which manipulated the passage of the income tax and the Federal Reserve System wanted America in the war. J.P. Morgan, John D. Rockefeller, Colonel House, Jacob Schiff, Paul Warburg, and the rest of the Jekyll Island conspirators were all deeply involved." World War I was a financial bonanza for the international bankers, but it was a catastrophe of such magnitude for the United States that few even today grasp its importance. The war reversed our traditional foreign policy of non-involvement, and we have been enmeshed almost constantly ever since in perpetual wars for perpetual peace. Winston Churchill once observed that all nations would have been better off had the U.S. minded its own business. Had we done so, he said, quote, "Peace would have been made with Germany, and there would have been no collapse in Russia leading to communism, no breakdown of government in Italy followed by fascism, and Nazism never would have gained ascendancy in Germany."